And victims of Scottish football's abuse scandal have called on the Scottish Government to launch an inquiry into the Celtic Boys Club. They took their case to Holyrood yesterday, just hours after a former coach at the club, 83-year-old Frank Kearney, was jailed for 4 years, convicted of 9 sex offences against youngsters.
Kenny Campbell and Andrew Gray were abused by the club's founder, Jim Torbett, who was jailed last year. Andrew's mother, Helene, joined Kenny at the Scottish Parliament yesterday, making the case for an inquiry.
I really hope that, I mean, they were there today and they were nice and they were listening to us, but I really hope that what you said wasn't just to sort of have us going away thinking, well, we've got somewhere. I just hope that they're going to put in place what they said to us today. That's all I wish for.
I think they will. I've got a positive feeling that they will.
Well, that's good, Kenny.
We deserve an independent inquiry. Somebody must be held to account for what's happened.
Well, Patrick McGuire from Thompsons Solicitors represents a number of survivors of the abuse at Celtic Boys Club. He joins me now. What is your reaction to what happened in court yesterday?
Well, I don't think I should comment on the length of sentence. All I can say is, though, that while I won't personally comment, many of my clients have already expressed their surprise at the length. For me, the real thing about yesterday in the case is that it shows yet again just the extent of the abuse that went on at Celtic's Boys Club. And then, of course, inevitably, you might say, hours later, Celtic Football Club issue yet another statement that's as bad, that's as meaningless, that's as heartless as all their other previous comments in this issue.
But they have got a point, haven't they, the football club? They're expressing regret and sympathy for the victims of who suffered abuse. So they still insist the Boys Club is an entirely separate organisation, and that is the case, isn't it?
No, that is absolutely not the case. What the statement does is peddle once more the line that they've been given a trust by a lawyer or something like that to try and provide them with some sort of loophole to get out of this. But no, that's not the case, that there's no link. It's completely and utterly false. We, as you commented, have many survivors who came forward to us. We have been gathering evidence each week more and more as more and more survivors come forward. Last time I was on this show, I was quite categorical in my position about the extent of connection between the two organisations. That position's only got stronger financially, factually, organisationally. The two are utterly intertwined. The truth is now, as more evidence has came forward, Celtic Boys Club was the de facto and probably more than that youth system for Celtic Football Club.
Is it a financial motivation here, Patrick McGuire, to try and link the two organisations?
Is the motivation of survivors a financial one? No, it's a matter of justice and financial justice. Celtic Football Club benefited year on year from the conduct of Celtic Boys Club in terms of the players that came forward. The reality is, you couldn't really become a player at Celtic Football Club without going through Celtic Boys Club. Celtic got the benefits, they therefore have to face the responsibility. It's really that simple. Well, the financial motivation is on the part of Celtic trying to do a Pontius Pilate job.
Yeah.
It's frankly horrific.
Well, let me just say again that Celtic Football Club say that they were entirely separate, and I know that you disagree with that. But just finally, if I can ask you, do you think that an independent inquiry would be useful here? We heard Kenny Campbell there calling for it a minute ago.
I personally would entirely support that position. The reality is what needs to happen, though, is Celtic need to open up to negotiations with us. And if they don't, they'll be facing their day in the civil courts very, very soon.
Patrick McGuire, thank you very much indeed for joining us from Thompson's Solicitors.